Good morning, students. Welcome to English class. Today we will be seeing part 2 of worksheet number 5. So here I start. Let's see. That is lesson number 5 question tag. Question number 3. Add a question tag. I made tea in the morning. Children, we all know that in this lesson there are few steps. Number 1, we copy the sentence as it is, then we add a comma, and then if there is a modal auxiliary, that is a helping verb, in the sentence we bring it out, and if the sentence is positive we make it negative, and if it is negative we make it positive. That's the vice versa, followed by a pronoun and then a question mark. So here I start. Let's see. Number 1, I made tea in the morning. So the answer will be, I made tea in the morning. Didn't I? Why didn't I? Because there is no auxiliary verb, so we are taking did as the auxiliary verb, and as the sentence is positive we'll make it negative. Let's move to the second one. I am taking a big chance. Children, we all have seen in this explanation video that whenever the auxiliary verb is am, we don't take it as a am, we change it into are, and as the sentence is positive we are gonna make it negative, and so the answer will be, I am taking a big chance, aren't I? Question mark. Children, please try to make a note of one thing, that in case if you forget to add a question mark, your answer doesn't get valid, you know, it is inappropriate answer. Why? Because the topic itself is question tag, and in case if you skip adding question mark, the answer is of no use. So in this way, let's see the third one. John can save it on the armor. Let's see what is the auxiliary verb, that is can. Let's remove can out. The sentence is positive, we are gonna make it negative. So the answer is, John can save it on the armor, can't she? Question mark. Moving to the next one. The hermit again gave no answer. Children, I can see the sentence is negative because the use of no is given in the sentence, and as there is no auxiliary verb, so we'll take use of did, as the main verb is in past tense, gave. So we'll use did, and the answer will be, the hermit again gave no answer. Did he? Question mark. Coming to the next one. Professor Vikram Sarabhai was a scientist. I can see my auxiliary verb as was, so let's remove was out, and as the sentence is positive we are going to make it negative, and so the answer is, Professor Vikram Sarabhai was a scientist, wasn't he? Question mark. Moving to the next topic, that is lesson number 6, voice, and the question goes, question number 4, change the voice. Children, you all have seen that there are two type of voice, active voice and passive voice. What is active voice? Where the subject is doer of an action, and in passive voice the subject is, like, you know, not active. And in active voice you always have subject, verb, object, whereas in passive voice you have object plus V3, that is the verb third form, past participle of the verb, yes, plus by plus subject. So let's see how the exercise goes. I can save it on the armor. Yes, here children, I is subject, can save is verb, it is object, on the armor is extra are the extra words. So let's arrange the passive voice. First we'll bring the object ahead, so it. Let's change the verb into v3. It can be saved, that's the v3 past participle. Extra on the armor by plus subject. So when I goes to that place, I becomes me, and the answer will be it can be saved on the armor by me. I hope you are following it. Let's see the second one. I took a new name every month. Let's divide how the division goes. I is subject, took is a verb, a new name object, everyone extra words. So let's bring the object first. A new name, let's do v3 of the verb, was taken extra every month by I going to the next place and changing into another pronoun, that is me. So the answer is a new name was taken every month by me. Let's see the third one. Singh was selected for the Empire Pilot training course. Children, Singh is a subject here, was selected verb. There is no object for the Empire Pilot training course is extra. Now when the object is absent, in that case what we are supposed to do? Of course we need to find out the object. So here the sentence is Singh was selected. So the question is, who might have selected the Singh? Of course, as Singh was a pilot, so maybe the authorities. So I can take the word authorities as my object. Bringing my object at the first place, that is the authorities was selected, ko change into v3, selected. Bringing the subject, that is Singh, and then the extra. So the answer goes, the authorities selected Singh for the Empire Pilot training course. Going to the next one. Nature soothes and nurtures us. So my nature is my subject, soothes and nurtures is the verb, us is object. Let's bring object at the first place, object coming to the first place, that goes and become we. Making the v3 of the verbs, we are soothed and nurtured, following by and bringing the subject at the end, so nature, and the answer becomes we are soothed and nurtured by nature. Coming to the last one, her angry question still shakes me. Let's do the division. Her angry question, subject, still shakes, verb, me, object. Bringing object at the first place, that is I. Making verb into v3, so I am still shaken, followed by, so by, and bringing the subject. Her angry question. So the answer goes, I'm still shaken by her angry questions. Children, I hope you have followed it.
Now move on to our last part of the worksheet, which is based on the grammar topic. The topic is infinitive. Pick out an infinitive from the given sentences and use it in your own sentences. Children, what you have to do? You have to choose out the infinitive first. After selecting out the infinitive, you have to make the another sentence using the same infinitive. Clear, everybody? See the first question. I am able to talk to you using the mic. What is infinitive here? To talk. Then you have to make a new sentence using the same infinitive. So write down the new sentence. The headmaster wants to talk to you about the annual function. Now, move on to the second one. I might be able to get into the young man's confidence. What is the infinitive over here? The infinitive is to get. So, you have to make the new sentence. I wanted to get a good book from the library. Clear everyone? Now, move on to the third one. To see a world in a grain of sand and a heaven in a wildflower. What is the infinitive over here? To see. So, you have to make a new sentence using the same infinitive. I went to the beach because I wanted to see the ship. Now, fourth one. Mahatma Gandhi said, if we are to teach real peace in this world, we shall have to begin with the children. What is the infinitive over here? To teach. So, the sentence will be any sentence you can write. My mother wanted to teach me good manners. Now come to the fifth one. An old fisherman is unable to catch any fish for 84 days. What is the infinitive over here? To catch. So you have to use the same infinitive and make the new sentence. So the sentence is, the fielder tried to catch the ball. Clear everybody? With this, we have completed our worksheet number 6. Thank you.